welcome to Comic Island. My name is Arden, and today we're going to talk about the Black Adam movie. So, for years, literally for years now, there has been endless talk about making a movie out of what was once called the Captain Marvel franchise, but is now, to avoid confusion with the Marvel company, the Shazam franchise. For a long time, there's been talk of featuring Shazam in his own movie, with Warner Brothers partnering with New Line Cinema to produce something along those lines. Dwayne The Rock Johnson was cast as Black Adam years ago to that end, and he was supposed to be featured as a sort of anti-hero and this interesting modern sort of mirror to Shazam, a more idyllic and straightforward hero with boyhood ideals and a personality along those lines. Black Adam is an interesting adversary to the modern Shazam because of that, and it would have been a pretty cool idea. But those plans have been shelved. Geoff Johns stated last year any Shazam movie coming out wouldn't feature the Black Adam character. Instead, it seems like Warner Brothers is going forward with a Black Adam solo movie starring Dwayne Johnson. Or at least that's one of the dozens of movies they've announced and have some form of plans for, some of which are and aren't in DCEU canon. It's very confusing and definitely questionable, but the Black Adam movie does have some things counting for it. For one thing, I've always thought that Dwayne Johnson would make for an excellent Black Adam. He not only looks the part to an incredible extent, but I think it would be a very interesting challenge for him as an actor, a very different character for him to really sink his teeth into, but one that I think he's capable of. From what I've seen of The Rock as an actor, and apologies for that name slipping out there, he's a great actor with a pretty good range, surprising for someone who used to be a wrestler, and up until now has more typically starred in action movie roles as a very sort of one-liner typical action movie star. But if you look at his performance in movies such as Moana or even The Scorpion King, he does have the ability to channel some different energies than a typical action movie star, such as what would be required of Black Adam. So that's interesting, but whether or not this movie is going to be good is really going to depend on the writer and director. Right now, Henry Gayden is attached to write this movie, and he's responsible for a movie called Earth to Echo. Basically, a schmaltzy E.T. ripoff that's not the best movie in the world, but is a decent kids movie that works more than it doesn't. It's creative enough and wasn't a terrible movie, but doesn't exactly immediately strike me as a promising writer for the Black Adam movie. As for the director, according to whatever Hollywood rumor mill I got this from, David F. Sandberg is the frontrunner for the project. He's directed two horror feature films, Lights Out and Annabelle Creation. Both films have been received pretty well, even if they aren't universally acclaimed. I'm not so convinced that a horror director would be the best choice for a movie like Black Adam, which I would always view as a more typical superhero story with some tragic elements involved in it. And that kind of gets into what this story would be. My instinct and the thing that I would go with, and given Geoff Johns' involvement with the company and the fact that he was one of the writers of this story, would be to draw from Black Adam's story and role in the comic book event called 52. In it, Black Adam has a really interesting part, a very tragic element to his character that is nicely explored and ultimately culminates in some pretty moving stuff that leads to him going on this crazy rampage the rest of the world has to deal with in a very interesting way. To do something like that on the big screen would be the coolest thing I think they could do with Black Adam. But somehow I just don't think they could do it. For one thing, it wouldn't really introduce Black Adam's character very well. And while they could tell his origins through flashbacks and stuff like that, I somehow suspect DC wouldn't instinctively go from that and would prefer a more traditional origin story route for their first Black Adam movie. And that's a damn shame, because it wouldn't be necessary whatsoever. If they did a Shazam movie first that introduces Black Adam as a villain, and then make a Black Adam solo movie that focuses on the 52 stuff, it would work perfectly and would sell everyone on a Black Adam series of movies. But somehow I don't think they're going to do that, and instead they're going to tell a murky origin story with a dark twist to it until Black Adam ends up having to fight some generic villain saving the day and becoming a reluctant hero of Kondak, or something along those lines. Look, I could be wrong. I would love to be wrong about this. I just am extremely skeptical about that. I somehow suspect they're going to go a more traditional and boring route. And that's a real shame because the DCEU needs to be more interesting than that. Meanwhile, the Shazam movie has completely finished filming and has the exact same director attached to it as Black Adam supposedly does. David F. Sandberg is responsible for the Shazam movie, and we're already starting to get promotional material out of it. Black Adam and Dwayne Johnson are nowhere to be found on the cast list, though it doesn't necessarily mean that we won't get some sort of cameo concerning Black Adam, or a very late appearance of him in some sort of post-credit scene. Nevertheless, the conspicuous absence of Black Adam is interesting, and reflects the ever-changing, completely unpredictable pattern of DCEU movies at this point. I'm excited for Shazam and actually kind of pumped that they are relying on Dr. Sylvia as that movie's villain instead of the more tempting and tantalizing movie villain in Black Adam. But it does leave the future and plans of ever seeing Black Adam on feature film in some form or another very ambiguous. When or if we're gonna see Dwayne Johnson as this character is unclear at this time.
So we'll see what happens, we'll see how things go, but I am cautiously optimistic, as I am with the DCEU at this point. I'm really hoping, like fingers crossed, that the Wonder Woman sequel and the Aquaman movie coming out this year will be the first chapter in DCEU turning things around. They are, at this point, desperately behind the MCU, not just in terms of where they are story-wise, but in terms of quality and what they've done with their audience and how they've earned audience loyalty. Every single DCEU movie has made less than the one before it, and that's not a good sign for turning things around. But they need to, and they're the only people out there who can meaningfully compete with the MCU at this point, so we need this movie to really work. Right now, I don't think there's any good sign of Black Adam being a good example of DC turning things around in a meaningful way, aside from Dwayne Johnson being a really solid thing, and currently the only major unambiguous selling point going forward. I'm not convinced about this screenwriter or director. I don't think their track record speaks for itself enough for me to just be unambiguously excited about it the way I am about, say, Aquaman. So, we'll see. I really want this to be a thing because I like Black Adam, and like I said, I really like that 52 story. If they don't do it with the first Black Adam foray, then at the very least they can do it going forward in some form of sequel, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. But it would be the best thing for them to do to start strong, to bring in Sobek and Isis and all the other Black Adam characters that really made that 52 story special. I forget what that kid's name, but I'm forgetting him. You know who I'm talking about. Isis's brother ends up also being a major character in that story. And the four of them end up telling something really meaningful and truly tragic. The kind of thing that hurts when I think about it in a way that not a lot of other superhero stories do. So let me know what you guys think in the comments section below. Thanks for watching, and if you like Comic Island, be sure to check out our Patreon page in the video description below. Patrons get a say every week in the content we make for only $1 a month. Finally, don't forget to like, subscribe, and keep reading comics.